sunny time at Sonny Farms together. Let's be best friends and help to make each other smile. Let's have a sunny time at Sonny Farms together. Oh, won't you come and visit for a while? 'Cause when you share with me at Sonny Farms, I'm happy. Your smiling face helps me to have a special day. There's lots of things to learn together with my best friend. It's sunny time at Sonny Farm, so come and stay.
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to Sonny Farms. Oh, I'm so glad that you could join us today. We're going to have a super duper duper day. I just feel it because, well, lots of good things are happening here today on the farm. I mean, I have all my work caught off after. I mean, I watered the flowers, and I did my gardening, and I was even over to visit neighbor Bill for a little bit, and, well, I've been picking flowers and doing all kinds of great things, and now I have lots of time to spend with the boys and girls. So I know we're going to have a super duper day, and I love to start the day a certain way. You know what way I like to start the day? That's right, you guessed it, with a chuckle. All those bunnies have the silliest stories all the time, so let's go and see what Henrietta's up to and what kind of silly stories we had today. Okay, come on, boys and girls, let's go. Hi, Henrietta. How are you today? Well, you're looking well. Yeah, you're feeling great and all that. And, you know, you look elegant. Your color is always so vibrant. You know that? Yes, yes, it is. But do you think the bunnies have something? You can guarantee it. Okay. Oh, hey, Marshmallow has a silly story, and we haven't heard from Marshmallow for a while. Put your thinking cap on. Okay, got it on? What do French frogs eat? That's right. Ribbit, ribbit, that's right. But French frogs, what do they eat? How about French flies? Oh, I'm glad I don't have to eat French flies. No, that's not one of my delicacies. Mm-mm. And Lavender has a silly story, so let's see what Lavender has to say. French flies, I never heard of that. What kind of shoes are made out of banana skins? Oh, they're good to eat. Yeah, I like bananas, and but I never thought about shoes being made out of banana skins. But what about slippers? That's it. Roop is right. Woman, you go down if you step on that banana skin. Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? It's been good visiting with you. Good to start the day with a chuckle, right? And I think I'll see what the songbirds have to share, okay? Like, yeah, maybe they have a special song today. Okay, because you know what? I just love the songbirds. Why, they have the nicest songs week after week for us. And maybe they have something special for us today. So let's go right now to the songbirds.
Just minding my business. Life was a beautiful song. Didn't have a care or worry. Then you had come along. I fell in love with you first time in love with you. They make me blue. No, darling, I'm falling in a big way for sweet little you. My heart is jumping, oh, you started something with them there eyes. You'd better watch them if you're wise. They sparkle, they bubble, they're gonna get you in a whole lot of trouble. You're overworking them, there's danger lurking in them. I looked into them there eyes. You have got
up and oh, you started melting with them there. You'd better watch them if you're wise. They sparkle, they bubble, they'll get ya in trouble. There's danger lurking in them there.
And you know what? When I see your eyes, well, I just fall in love with you, too, because you've got the biggest eyes ever, and I want to see you. So come and visit Aunt Patsy on Sonny Farms, and then maybe you can get to see the songbirds right here, okay?
Word?
Oh, Webster, that's you. Yeah. You
have word?
We need a word for the day. I'm glad, Webster. Do you have a special word for Aunt Patsy?
What?
Oh, come on. Give me a special word. Hey, Teddy Bears. Oh, they are one of my favorite things. Thank you, Webster. Bye-bye.
Bye.
You know what? Teddy bears. Oh, I love teddy bears. I mean it. I really do love teddy bears. I mean, when Aunt Patsy was a little girl, I had so many. In fact, I still have some of my favorite teddy bears. But you know what? I think Henrietta's over there in the sunshine window with some little boys and a whole lot of teddy bears. So let's take a peek. Why, it looks like teddy bear land here. Hi there, Henrietta. And we have little boy Bradley with us. And Nathan's here, huh?
Hi.
Hi, sweethearts. Why, I never saw so many teddy bears. And Henrietta has her favorite teddy bear, too. Yeah, well, first of all, I want to know, what's your whole name?
Nathan Huber, Greg Huber.
Nathan Huber. Well, that's very good. Nathan, do you have a brother, Nathan? You do. What's his name?
Nicholas.
Nicholas. Now, is Nicholas older than you or younger than you?
Well, I'm 4, he's 3.
Oh, that makes him younger. That's a good way to explain it. Uh-huh, okay. And over here we have with us, what's your name?
Ryan.
And what's your other name? Little boy Bradley, huh? Yeah, and you have all these teddy bears with us today. But you know what, little boy Bradley? I wanted to ask you, do you have maybe a special joke for Aunt Patsy?
Why did a man throw butter out the window?
Why did he throw butter out the window? A man threw butter out the window? Why would someone throw butter out the window? Why?
He wanted to see a butterfly.
He wanted to see a butterfly. Do you like that? That is silly. Do you have any other jokes, little boy Bradley?
Well, my aged man throws a clock out the window.
Why did he throw a clock out the window? Why, this man throws lots of things out the window. I don't know. Why did he throw a clock out the window?
He wanted to see a time fly.
He wanted to see time fly. I like that, too. I like that one, Henry. Nathan, do you have a special joke for Aunt Patsy?
Hi. I have one on here.
In your pocket. May I have it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. He wrote his down. Well, this is very nice. Oh, that's really nice. He has his joke all written down for me. What has 88 keys but can't unlock any doors?
Piano.
A piano. I like that one. That's a good one, Nathan. But I was wondering, what do you think?
I have another joke.
Do you really? What's your other joke?
Why did a man bring a ladder to church?
Why did the man bring a ladder to church? I don't know. Who would take a ladder to church? What did he want to do?
He wanted to see a high mass.
Oh, he wanted to see high mass. Okay. That's all for all our Catholic viewers out there. A little bit of humor there. Do you have another one? Yeah.
What happened when the man jumped out the window?
What happened when the man jumped out the window?
He fell in the dirt.
Yeah, he would fall in the dirt. That's true. But you know what? I see here we have lots
have
of... Well, I want to talk to you about teddy bears first. Okay, then maybe we'll talk about jokes later. How many teddy bears do we have here today? How many think we have?
I don't know.
Oh, maybe more fingers than I have.
I know.
These are 10 fingers.
This one is Nathan's. This one's my sister's. This one is Aunt Mary Jo's. This one's Aunt Mary Jo's.
Is that right? Uh-huh. And which is your favorite bear, Nathan?
This one, that one, that one.
That one, that one, that one. Do you have names for any of your bears?
Yeah, Bear, Care Bear, and a Bear.
Care Bear, Bear?
I'll tell you which one is mine.
No, you can't go over there, sweetheart. I'll just get your bear over here. This one's yours, just big one, huh?
Uh-huh.
What's the name of this big bear here?
Frosty.
Frosty the bear. I like that. Oh, and he has a snow hat on and a scarf and everything, so I can see that you would call him Frosty the bear. You know what? I was just thinking, we talk about Care Bears, but these look like chair bears. They're all sitting on little chairs today. Aunt Patsy had a funny joke there, huh?
Dude,
you know what?
This one?
Yeah, you know what? I have some bears over there, like that little pink one over there. Can you hand me the one next to that pink one there? The other one, Ryan. Nathan, get me that other tan one too, sweetheart. This one makes noise. Listen to this.
That's my sister's.
Yeah.
And that one's my sister's. Both of them are my sister's.
And do they have any names?
I don't know.
What do you think we should name them? What do you think would be a good name for this bear?
I know.
How about Superman?
Well, that's a good name for a bear, Superman.
And this could be Teddy.
And this one's Teddy. Hey, those are two good names. You know what? Aunt Patsy has to name all of these bears today, and there are lots and lots of bears here today. And, you know, I think I'm going to let you here with Henrietta, all right? You want to take care of the bears for me for a while?
Yeah.
And I'm going to go over because I think I heard the puppets a minute ago, and they may get into too much trouble if I don't go see what's happening.
Right?
I'll see you.
Bye. Lots of teddy bears on Sonny Farms today. Oh, I'm so afraid. There's so many teddy bears here today, and they're so big, and I'm so little. Oh, I don't know. I think I need somebody to help me out. I wonder if it... Oh, it's you, Aunt Patsy. I thought it was a teddy bear coming to get me. I'm afraid, Aunt Patsy.
You're afraid?
Yeah.
Why would you be afraid, Rainbow?
Well, Aunt Patsy, you know, you said that teddy bears can be your friends and things like that, but I don't know. I'm a little nervous.
Yeah.
I mean, how would I carry them around? And what if I wanted the bear to sleep with me? Well, I'd have to sleep on the floor.
Yeah.
I just don't understand why teddy bears are so nice to be with. I mean, I would much rather sleep in a bed because they're just so big. They take up a whole bed.
Right. You know, well, I don't know why you would be afraid of them, though, Rainbow. I mean, teddy bears, you know, are nothing to be afraid of.
Lou, hi, y'all.
Hi there.
Hi, Aunt Patsy. Well, this is just the kind of day that's so moo, wonderful and all.
Right, yeah.
Oh, and moo fun.
Mm-hmm.
And oh, just moo exciting. I just love it.
Well, you must like teddy bears, too, then, Moo-Moo Belle.
Like teddy bears, too? Why, honey bunch, what in the world do you mean? Doesn't everyone love teddy bears? Well, of course they do. And I have my very own Moo Marvelous teddy bear that I talk to just about every day. Now, don't you dare breathe a word of that to Happy.
Well, you know what? I like teddy bears, too. It seems everybody likes teddy bears. Yeah.
I don't believe you talked to your teddy bear, Moo-Moo Belle.
Aunt Moo, yes, and I even sleep with my teddy bear every night. Well, I know it sounds silly and all since I am such a moo mature cow. But, well, we all need a little pacifier once in a while, Moo.
You mean you sleep with your teddy bear in the same bed?
Why, Moo, of course, Rainbow. You know that I have only one bed in my room. Why, what do you think? I sleep on the floor while my Teddy sleeps in my bed? Oh, that's a Moo joke, right? Well, this is Moo silly. Well, anyway, of course I sleep in the same bed.
Well, I didn't know that, Moo-Moo Bell.
Now, Rainbow, you mean we've been friends all this time and we've never introduced you to my Teddy?
No.
Well, darling, forgive me. I'll tell you what, I'll run right home, or maybe I'll stroll so I don't sweat. Now, although everyone knows Mom never sweats. Oh, and perspires because I just don't draw flies and all that. Anyway, I'll be right back and introduce you to my Teddy. Oh, I'm so excited. Now, don't go away, y'all, okay? I'm packing him out.
Well, bye. My goodness, Moo-Moo Bell can certainly get excited.
Aunt Patsy, I just remembered. I was supposed to start to bake my cookies right now.
No.
So I must really go.
Rainbow.
Well, I'll see you later, Aunt Patsy,
wait,
okay?
Rainbow, you can't leave.
Oh.
You can't leave. I mean, Moo-Moo Bell went to get her teddy bear to show you, and she's coming right back. That wouldn't be very polite.
But, she'll understand. Tell her, well, I'll talk to her some other time, you know, when she's forgotten about introducing me to her teddy. Okay, Aunt Patsy?
No, wait, Rainbow, are you afraid or something of these teddy bears?
Well,
my goodness, I don't think you have anything to worry about, and I really don't think you should leave because Moo-Moo Bell's going to be right back.
Well, you might think that they're nice, Aunt Patsy, because, well, you're 5 feet tall, and I'm only a little tiny little thing, and they're just so big. Well, I just think I'd rather not meet Teddy today, okay?
My goodness, look.
Ta-da! There's my teddy.
That's your teddy?
Moo, of course, Rainbow. Well, is there something wrong with you? What were you expecting, a real live grizzly or something? Why, of course this is my teddy. Isn't he sweet? My very own from when I was quite much more immature. But we know that was a very, very, very long time ago. Anyway, my teddy and I have been through a lot together.
Oh, he's so cute and he's so small. And, he looks so cuddly. It kind of surprised me.
Moo, yes, he is, of course. And he's so much mine, too, really.
Maybe I'd like to have my own teddy bear. Now that I saw how cute and cuddly yours is, Moo-Moo Bell, do you think that maybe there might be another teddy bear around for me?
Why, sure, honey. Well, I think so, don't you, Aunt Patsy? Well, we might find a teddy bear for her.
I think so. There must be a lot of nice little teddy bears around here. There were so many over there in the sunshine window. I think you ought to go and maybe take a peek.
Moo, yes.
Okay.
Well, I'll help you find one, Rainbow.
Okay.
I'm an expert on teddies.
Well, that sounds
all
great.
Right.
Thanks, Aunt Patsy, for talking, and we'll see you later.
Okay.
Bye now.
Bye.
All right, bye-bye. And don't go away, because we're going to be right back with a lot more of Sonny Farms after this message.
Let's have a sunny time at Sonny.
There were 12 disciples. Jesus called to help him. Simon Peter. Andrew. James. His brother John. Philip. And Thomas. Matthew. James, the son of Alphaeus. Thaddeus. Disciples, I am one of you. He is calling you. He is calling you to be his disciples. We his work must do. We his work must do.
Welcome back to Sunny Farms, boys and girls. You know what? I wonder, do each one of you have a special teddy bear?
No.
I bet you do.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Polly also has a special teddy bear, and his name is Freddy. You see him? He's getting kind of worn a little bit, but you know what? He's still my favorite teddy bear. I want to sing a song about him for you right now. Jonathan, would you hold this teddy bear for me? Okay, here we go. He's called Freddy the Teddy Bear. My favorite teddy bear was named Fred. He was missing an eye and had started to shed. But I just didn't care what the other kids said, 'cause Freddy the Teddy was special to me. Freddy the Teddy Bear, you're such a good friend of mine, 'cause whenever I'm lonely or sick or sad, you've always got the time to be a good friend of mine. Together when I was so young, but now that I'm older, I've found the one who's even more special than Freddy to me. He's like Freddy the Teddy Bear, and he's such a good friend of mine, 'cause whenever I'm lonely or sick or sad, he's always got the time to be a good friend of mine.
Very good. Let's clap for Polly. Come on, boys.
Thank you.
Boy, I tell you what, you know what? I wanted to ask the boys a question before, and I didn't ask them why they like teddy bears. And I'm going to ask Nathan first. Nathan, why do you like teddy bears?
Because I can sleep with them and they're so soft.
He likes to sleep with them, and they're very soft. That's Nathan. Thank you very much. And little boy Bradley, why do you like teddy bears?
Because I like to sleep with them, and I like to go bicycle with them.
Oh, he likes to take his teddy right along on his bicycle. Very, very good. And Robbie, do you like teddy bears?
I like them because they're soft. I like them because they go on my bike.
Very good. We have some people here that like to ride bikes, and Jonathan's getting a little sleepy there. Jonathan, why do you like teddy bears? Well, I think Jonathan's going to think about it for a while. I know he's holding Freddy the Teddy, but he just wants to think about why he likes teddy bears, huh? But you know what, boys and girls? Boys, look at, you know what? I think the sunflowers are beginning to blow. Mm-hmm.
Boy.
That's right. It's a special time on Sonny Farms because the sunflowers on Sonny Farms are blowing in the breeze, and I think they're trying to tell us. Will you read a story?
Please.
And that's the time Aunt Patsy has to read a story. And guess what story I have? Teddy bears are a blessing. It's a book all about teddy bears. Mm-hmm. Okay, here goes, all about teddy bears. Teddy bears are a blessing because you can hold them when you're lonely. And I like to do that with my teddy bear, to hold my teddy bear. That's right. Teddy bears are a blessing because they never tell you a snack or will spoil your supper. No, they don't. They don't spoil your supper. They're not at all. Okay? And teddy bears are a blessing because they're quiet when you want to be alone. Did you ever notice how quiet teddy bears are? Well, let's listen, boys, and listen to me. Shh. See that? Teddy bears are quiet. They're very quiet, especially when you want to be alone. They can be very, very quiet. Teddy bears are a blessing because they remind us that with God's help, all things are possible. You know, I never thought of a teddy bear like that, Polly. But that's true. And teddy bears can really be a blessing. Now, teddy bears are a blessing because they give you comfort and cheer. You know that? They can cheer you up. They can be your best friend. Why, they can be with you all the time. And they can listen to you, Polly, when nobody else wants to listen to you. Now, teddy bears are a blessing because they do everything that you love to do. Is that what your teddy bear does? Everything that you like to do, that's what your teddy bear does. Why? Teddy bears are a blessing because they help you dream of faraway places. You know that's true. You can play make-believe with teddy bears. Well, you can pretend that you're going to the moon, or you can pretend that you're in Disney World and you're with Winnie the Pooh or one of the Pooh Bears, or, well, you can pretend all kinds of things. You can pretend with your teddy bear that you're like Smokey the Bear and you put out forest fires.
How about Care Bears?
Yeah, Care Bears are fun too, and teddy bears are a blessing because they love to share with their friends. You know that's true, teddy bears always share. They always share everything with their friends. Mm-hmm. Now, teddy bears are a blessing because they take bubble baths with you. There are some teddy bears that you can put in the bathtub. And I don't think they cry or anything when they had to take a bath. They probably love to take bubble baths. So there are all kinds of things that teddy bears do. Teddy bears are a blessing because they always are waiting for you when you come home. Now, you know that's the truth, Polly?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what Freddy used to do?
All the time, yes.
Freddy would always be there waiting for you when you would come home. And that's what I like about my special teddy bear. And teddy bears, because, and the most important reason in the book is, they accept you just the way you are. You know what? They said so many good things here about accepting people the way they are and being your best friend. Reminds me of Jesus and the song you were singing about, Polly.
That's right.
Because that was the special friend you were talking about in that song, wasn't it?
You're right, Aunt Patsy. He was.
You know what? Boys and girls, if you want to come and visit Aunt Patsy on Sonny Farms, maybe bring your favorite teddy bear along to see, you know, and show the rest of the boys and girls. Come and visit with us and be here on story time. Our address is going to be on in, oh, just a few seconds. Get a pencil and paper and write it down, and we'll have you come and join us on Sonny Farms. Okay, boys, now do you have your waivers already?
Already?
Let me see. Are you all wait? Jonathan, you don't have your waiver ready. I don't know if Jonathan brought his waiver along today, but I hope so, because you know what? It's time. This is the sad part of the show, but we'll see you again, okay? Because it's time to say goodbye to you from Sonny Farms, and I'll see you in a while. Remember, till we meet again, boys and girls, wear your sunshiny smile from Sonny Farms and all the teddy bears today.
Mom, did I do?
Let's have a sunny time at Sonny Farms together. Let's be best friends and help to make each other smile. Let's have a sunny time at Sonny Farms together. Oh, won't you come and visit for a while? 'Cause when you share with me at Sonny Farms, I'm happy. Your smiling face helps me to have a special day. There's lots of things to learn together with my best friend. It's sunny time at Sonny Farm, so come and stay.
Mm-hmm.